So that means it's blind bone time battle. Are they all in place?
They certainly are.
Then would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? Okay, panel, we'll go one question at a time. Bates' law prevails. You have about 2 minutes, and let's start with Soupy Sales.
Thank you. Well, that was a rousing ovation, Mr. Guest. Is that because they knew your work from records in the nightclub field?
Yes, I would say so.
Donna?
Do we also know you because of your television appearances?
Somewhat.
Jerry?
Have you had your own television show in the last couple of years?
No, I have not.
Arlene?
Records in the nightclub field, does that mean that you are a very popular singer?
Yes.
Okay.
Subi?
Well, when you do, are you a brunette?
No, I'm not.
Donna?
Have you had a hit record within this year?
Yes, I am.
Jerry?
Boy, part about not having your own television show throws me because I'm going to take a guess. If I'm wrong, I guess I'll have to take off my mask.
That's right.
Is it Ellen Reddy?
No, now you have to take off your mask.
So I just
no idea how far off you are.
Are you a rock singer?
No, I'm not.
Subi? I'll tell you, those of you who are left with your masks on, that we are not messing around.
I'm hip. Do you sing? Are you very big in the country western field?
No, not yet.
Donna?
That would be nice.
Not country. It's got to be an opera singer then. That's a lot of wishing.
Do you want to pass, Donna?
Yeah, I can't think of another field.
Arlene?
Well, are you a blues singer?
I do sing blues, yes.
Soupy?
Oh.
Do you record for Capitol?
No, I don't.
Donna?
Are you appearing in New York right now?
No, not presently.
Arlene?
Oh.
I'm having such fun over here.
Sorry, I can't. Are you hip?
You are gonna...
I'm gonna kill myself right now. All right, I'll pass to Soupy. He knows
Soupy?
Everything.
Were you on Broadway in the last 6 or 7 months?
No.
Donna?
Do you play the piano?
Yes, I do.
Arlene?
While you sing?
Sometimes.
Arlene?
Where are you guys?
I just can't get over
it. It's somebody big. I know it's somebody big.
Had a hit record.
Go ahead, Dursu.
I just thought take a guess at it. Is it Hazel Scott?
No, now you can take off your mask. Yeah.
My favorite.
All right, the time is up, folks. You're not going to believe it. This is Aretha Franklin. I just think nobody could believe you were here, and that's what really happened.
It.
I thought Soupy would guess that.
I have 8 of your albums, and I just play them all the time.
You are so thin.
A little bit.
What occurred?
Not too much. attitude and determination.
How much did you take off?
About 20 or 25 pounds.
That's terrific. How long did it take?
About 3 to 4 months.
That's really sensational.
Does it affect your singing?
No.
You know, there's a theory that if you're heavier, it makes your voice richer. Your voice has not changed.
I thought that for a moment, but I found that really not to be true.
When you're singing a song, what is the main thing you try to do?
Feel.
Well, you feel it and you make us feel it too. I mean, it's unbelievable what you do. How did you learn to sing that way? Is it just native to you? It's in you? Or did you learn from someone? Were you influenced by someone?
No, I think it was...
I mean, you're really one of a kind.
Somewhat natural, and I did sing in in the young people's choir in my father's church.
Yeah.
I started there, and they are here.
You know, it's marvelous when somebody with a really gigantic talent at anything comes around. And it's a hard question to ask, I'm going to ask you, but what do you think talent is?
What do I think talent is?
Because you got so much of it, you must have some notion.
You got something going on.
Did you study music? Are you like a... Can you read?
No, I don't. I can read a melody line somewhat, but I don't read music.
Then how can you play?
By ear.
That's incredible and the most depressing thing I ever heard in my life.
Sure, you go and study and study and kill yourself and you wind up with nothing, right?
Well, you Errol Garner couldn't read and he plays mm-hmm. some.
Uh-huh. Hmm?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then he studied for a while. Now, what is it, if you could do anything you want to do, and I suspect that you now are in a position to do anything you want to do, what would it be?
To keep on doing what I'm doing and do it good.
You know, we in New York are so hungry to have you come here and perform, and it just seems like you are never here. Are you going to ever come here and do something for us?
Yes, I am. I was just in the Apollo in March, and very possibly we'll be at Radio City. I certainly hope so.
You know, I think it's marvelous that you play the Apollo, because an awful lot of people, when they get big in the black community, stop playing there, mm-hmm. and it's a mistake. But I wish you'd come up down and play with us some, too.
Of course.
Will you?
Come downtown.
I mean, downtown, yeah. Listen, you are the best.
Thank you.
Thank you
so
for
much.
Coming on the show.
Thank you.
We'll be back with more What's My Line after this message. Mystery guest, enter and sign in, please. At a time. You have roughly 3 minutes. Fate's law prevails, and let's start with Jim Bob.
That was a rousing ovation. The kind of an ovation that a sports crowd might come up with. Are you a sports figure?
I guess you could call it that.
Yes?
But you would make a big mistake, Army.
There seemed to be a wave, a double wave. Is there more than one person there?
Yeah.
What was that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Well, is it because they recognize you because of your work on television?
Yes.
Marcia?
Are all or several of you, whatever, on a regular television series?
No.
No. No complain back.
Jim?
Yeah. We have to guess the name of his pet parrot, I think. It sounded like a parrot voice, didn't it? Anyway. Did we establish that it was a sports figure, didn't we? Yes.
No, we established that it was not.
Oh, that it was not a sports figure. Okay.
And that there was more than one.
Are you a comedy team?
Sometimes.
Oh, listen. Are you man and wife?
No.
Are there four of you?
Yes.
Marcia?
Oh, four, I don't know. You're not counting, do you sing?
Yes.
Yeah.
Jim?
Wait a second. Singers, four, sometimes comedy. Wouldn't be the Pointer Sisters.
Yes, <okay. laughs> Great voices. Terrific. Now, where are you? First of all, tell us who is Sue, will you?
I'm Ruth.
I'm Amika.
I'm Bonnie.
Jim.
All right. Now, whatever happened to Bonnie June?
There you are. Right there.
Listen, how did you get the idea to dress this way?
Poverty.
How long have you been in that? Really, I mean, your success is so enormous now, and everybody says, oh, it's an overnight thing, and of course, nothing's overnight.
No. And even about a year. About a year now, as we are now, about a year.
And how long have you been working together all together?
Oh, off and on all our lives.
Where are you all from? Where are you from?
Oakland, California.
Yeah.
Now, what made you decide to be performers? Were just four girls around the house and decided to whoop it up a little bit?
No, it started gradually, you know. We used to sing and shake.
Did your style develop that way, too?
Yeah, gradually.
I don't know what happened. It just...
Accidentally, this became our image because of the photography session, and we happened to be dressed in old clothes.
Were those songs that you sing all the time songs of your childhood, early childhood?
No, we've never heard those songs before.
How about that?
We've never heard anything but hymns and anthems.
Really? Is that true?
Yeah.
Well, what do your parents do?
Preach.
That's why you only heard hymns and anthems?
That's right.
Now, are they tall? Are your parents tall?
Yes. Yes.
I just think that's sensational. How many numbers in your repertoire are there?
Oh, my goodness. How many numbers?
Like when you do a show, how many shows a night do you do?
We've been doing two shows a night.
Are they the same show or do you change it?
Sometimes we change it.
So you have how many arrangements, let's say? 50, 20, 10?
Oh, I don't know.
I don't know either.
About
15.
We don't have
to. But whatever it is, you're really breaking it up. Can you sing your way over to the panel?
Oh, yeah.
We'll be your friend.
In order. Ladies and gentlemen, children too, these brown babies gonna boogie for you. They gonna turn around, they gonna touch the ground. They gonna step back, and boogie on down. Hands up. Cha-cha.